arranged the Fiji and President of COP23, the Honorable Frank Bainimarama, President of the Federal Republic of Germany, His Excellency, Mr. Frank Walter Steinmeier, the Chancellor of the Federal Republic of Germany, the Honorable Angela Merkel, the Mayor of the City of Bonn, Mr. Ashok Sundararajan, Heads of States and Governments, Heads of Delegations and Members of Civil Society Organizations, all representing their respective countries, Honorable Cabinet Ministers, Your Excellencies, High Commissioners, Ambassadors and Members of the Diplomatic Corps, distinguished guests, all friends joining us remotely from COP23 and around the world, ladies and gentlemen, hello, Isambul Renak and greetings to you all. It is a great pleasure to be with you today as we create a digital link between Fiji and Bonn. Thank you to everyone who is joining us, both here in Suva and around the world, for the second and final live event, where we will witness performances that showcase the impact of climate change in the Pacific and how we are working together for a brighter, climate-friendly future. For us, song and dances are woven into the fabric of our societies and give color and meaning to just about every important moment in our national lives. They convey messages about our ancestors, our environment, and the importance of community and fellowship. We are about to witness and enjoy a mixture of traditional and contemporary performances that tell stories about the changing climate and our people's relationship with their natural surroundings and with each other. For our friends watching from around the world, and particularly for those gathered in Bonn, we hope these performances remind you of what we are fighting for. Let them reinvigorate your sense of urgency to address the great challenges of climate change and inspire you in your important work. We in the Pacific are watching the proceedings at COP23 with great interest and are looking for an outcome that makes a strong connection between what happens in Bonn and the lives of ordinary people. All those with the power to act must do so, because climate change ultimately threatens every single person on Earth. Join your voices with ours and let us all unite for a better and brighter future. Further, faster, together. And God bless you all. Dankeschön, Nawalev, and thank you.
Take a moment and think of a time when there was absolute fear. Listen, listen carefully. A hush crushing thunder on our rooftops. Hear the sound of the angry wind tearing and falling objects. Gigantic waves swiping and gulping everything in its path. I remembered that day, February 2016. Winston destroyed Fiji and made life very hard. What did I do wrong? Why is this happening? Open your eyes. This is serious. It is real, and yes, it is growing. This destruction was an example of the adversities of climate change. Dear friends, Bula, leadership, action, and COP23. Climate is defined as a change in weather. It affects everyone. I believe in the words of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., who stated, and I quote, that there is such a thing as being too late, unquote. That's right. Time is upon us. We need to act boldly and set aside our political agendas in favor of our young people. On that note, hasn't been hot lately? Hasn't been quite cooler at night? Yes. Scientists predicted that it would take 200 years for our planet to warm up. But yet, they have found that the temperature has risen above 1.1 degrees Celsius. I am afraid to go out during the day The nights are very cold and I need a thicker blanket to keep me warm. I would like to share some of the scary things happening to us on Earth. In Fiji, for instance, reports has recorded a 6 millimeter rise in sea level per year. This indeed true, as our friends of Vuni the Waloa, who became the nation's first community to relocate due to climate change. Secondly, scientists have indicated that tropical cycles will be stronger than ever and that there will be more droughts and heat waves. Similarly, reports has recorded that our neighbors, the Marshall Islands, a dipole, are on the verge of extinction as their future hangs in balance. Unquote. Now what can our leaders do? John Maxwell stated a leader is, and I quote, the one who knows the way, goes the way, and shows the way, unquote. Our Prime Minister, Mr. Frank Bainimarama, who is also the president of COP23, is a brave man. He tries to find solutions for a safer and sustainable future. He is showing us the way forward. My dear friends, it has led me to act in what I believe in saving our Earth. I have a mission to accomplish. As a student and a leader of my school, I have begun my contribution in my own little way to contest climate change. Little things do matter. I have simply followed the use of 3 R's, recycle my papers and cards, reuse my own drinking bottle, and reduce by using energy-saving lights in school and at home. Additionally, my Dukshar Girls' School has joined me in challenge. We have been a health-promoting school for the past 2 years. Smiling fresh plants in our reused containers with green chipotle under our gates. Reused tarts are cut and hung as a decoration. Mind you, there is a no burning policy in school. I assure you that there are many more activities outlined for this year. This is a positive movement to change the mindset of our young and old citizens. Ladies and gentlemen, the existence of COP23 has been a godsend. It is an informal name for the 23rd Conference of the Parties to the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. Leaders around the world must come together to ensure that things are on the right track. Our COP23 vision sets us to ensure that there is implementation, progress, consultation, and dialogue. You see, Fiji has also vowed to completely use renewable resources by 2030. That is totally awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, it is important that you remember, climate change is a world issue. You and I can make our little footprints on the planet to state that we have done our part. Listen, hear Mother Earth's plea. Oh, there is such sadness in her voice. She needs our help. We need to take care of her. She needs you and I. Dear friends all over the world, if you believe in me, I beg you to please stand and pledge with me in honor for our world to be free, to live, and repeat these words after me. I promise to keep Earth clean and safe. I will always reuse, reduce, and save what I can. I will inspire everyone to save our planet, to make positive changes, and to save our planet. Vinaka.